Hi, PerspectiveWeather.com meteorologist Paul Dorian here on Wednesday, April 10th. A pretty nice morning here in the Mid-Atlantic region. It'll be generally a nice day with plenty of sunshine, somewhat cooler than yesterday following the passage of a cool frontal system. But the big story across the nation in terms of weather will be a blizzard, a springtime blizzard that will rage from later today through much of the day on Thursday in an area from around Denver, Colorado, to Minneapolis, Minnesota. In fact, we're looking here at the latest NOAA weather warnings map across the nation. This entire area in orange is where there are blizzard warnings right now. And again, it's roughly from the area of Denver, Colorado to Minneapolis, northeastern Colorado, across much of Nebraska and South Dakota into western and central Minnesota. Winter storm warnings in existence farther north of there. In northern Minnesota, low pressure will intensify rapidly coming out of the Rockies and into the central plains later today and tonight, going into the day on Thursday. In fact, the low pressure itself will drop so dramatically over the next 24 to 36 hours or so, it could result in wind gusts in this blizzard warning zone of 55 or 60 miles per hour over the next 24 or 36 hours or so. The combination of heavy wet snow that could accumulate up to 1 to 2 feet in some parts of the central and northern plains, with those very intense wind gusts up to 55 or 60 miles per hour, certainly can lead to some power outages during this upcoming blizzard in the central and northern plains. To the south of the low pressure system itself, we have wind warnings. And again, that's as a result of an intense pressure gradient that will develop over the next 12 to 24 hours or so. We'll see that on the computer forecast models over the next couple of minutes. But again, low pressure will form right over Colorado and then move to the north and east and intensify dramatically over the next 24 to 36 hours or so. Well, here's the current surface map, rather benign looking in the Mid-Atlantic region. Plenty of sunshine today. A cool frontal system dropping south and east. Again, cooler today compared to yesterday and downright chilly tonight. Low temperatures should drop to the 30s in many of the suburbs along the I-95 corridor and the 40s in the big cities. But big story is here, this developing low pressure system out over Colorado right here. We'll see in a moment very strong upper level energy passing on top of this surface low pressure system over the next several hours, and that will help to intensify it as it pushes to the north and east, and a blizzard, all-out springtime blizzard to the north and west of the track of that low pressure system. 1 to 2 feet of snow possible in parts of Nebraska, South Dakota, all the way up from Colorado to Minnesota, and on the south side, tremendous pressure gradient will cause high wind gusts in that part of the nation as well. Well, let's take a look at the 500 millibar height anomaly forecast maps from last night's 6Z GFS model run. And here is the main story here, just a tremendous shot of energy in the upper part of the atmosphere. Right now, some surface low pressure is sitting over Colorado. As soon as this moves overhead over the next several hours, that dramatic intensification will begin. And we'll see as it moves forward in time, it slides to the north and east and again to the north and west of the surface low, an all-out blizzard over the next 24 to 36 hours or so. And by Friday morning, that moves all the way up into the northern plains. But again, from Colorado to Minnesota, blizzard conditions later today through much of the day on Thursday. And then here we go, high pressure ridging in the eastern part of the nation. But the next frontal system arrives here on Friday night. Here we go into the weekend. We'll see. You start to get another wave of energy in the upper part of the atmosphere that works its way across the nation and reaches the Mid-Atlantic region by early next week. Looks like a cold shot comes associated with this upper-level feature by the midday or later in the day on Monday, and will be downright windy and cold by Monday night here in the Mid-Atlantic region. Well, now let's take a look at the surface forecast maps from last night's 6C GFS model run. And here we go, relatively weak low pressure right now over Colorado, but that vigorous wave of energy in the upper part of the atmosphere is about to set off a dramatic intensification over the next 24 to 36 hours or so. Let's keep moving forward now, and here we go. It was a 992 millibar low, and by tonight, 979 slides into the Central Plains. Heavy snow starting to set up from Colorado across Nebraska and South Dakota, and this tremendous pressure gradient will result in very strong winds, not only near the low pressure area, but also to the south, where will be relatively dry in terms of precipitation, but strong wind gusts possible across the panhandle of Texas, New Mexico, associated with this unfolding blizzard. And that slides to the north and east, just heavy, heavy snow, wet snow across South Dakota and Minnesota during the afternoon, evening hours on Thursday. And this low pressure system still in existence in a very strong form by later tomorrow night, going into the early morning hours on Friday. It's sitting over Minnesota, with much of Minnesota, even North Dakota, still snowing at this time, and very strong winds. Here we have a frontal system headed towards the Ohio Valley, and that'll produce some rain showers here in the Mid-Atlantic region by late Friday afternoon, or more likely Friday night. It looks like that'll get on out of here by Saturday morning. Here's the frontal passage Friday night into early Saturday. And it looks like we may squeeze out a pretty decent day here in the Mid-Atlantic region on Saturday. But then another wave of low pressure forms during the day on Saturday across the south central U.S. And that slides up to the north and east, and looks like periods of rain likely in much of the Mid-Atlantic region from at least later Sunday into the day on Monday. And as we talked about a couple of minutes ago, there's rain will continue in early Monday, and then a cold shot arrives with increasing northwest winds by midday or afternoon on Monday. And it looks like quite a chilly, windy time period here come late Monday into Tuesday in the Mid-Atlantic region. One final note here, this particular part of Nebraska is where the flooding really intensified over the last several weeks, mainly due to excessive snow over the winter, excessive cold over the late winter, and that resulted in some frozen grounds just beneath the surface during the initial stages of the snow melting season. This particular blizzard, of course, will not help out the situation. There may be some rain initially, then a changeover to snow again in that part of Nebraska where flooding has been a big concern. So again, a worsening of the flooding situation likely with this upcoming blizzard over parts of the Central Plains, again due to excessive cold and snow. Really, that's the main culprit for this particular flooding problem this spring. So the big story will be a blizzard from Colorado to Minnesota over the next 24 to 36 hours or so. That's it for now. For PerspectiveWeather.com, I'm meteorologist Paul Orion.